Hey, YouTubers, thought I would take a little bit of time to straighten out the mystery about 1982 Lincoln Cents. This first slide right here that I'm going to show you shows a large date on the left-hand side and a small date on the right-hand side. And there's a little bit of question as to which is which, so I'll just give you a really easy way to tell right now. The large date, look at the 8. The 8 is a little flat and mushy kind of looking, and the inside holes of the 8 on the top and the bottom are about the equal size. Now, if you look over on the right-hand side and you'll see the small date, you'll notice that the top hole is a lot smaller than the bottom hole. Now, if you look at the 2s, the 2 is your biggest clue. On the large date, the 2 has a very straight stem in the middle, and it looks like it was kind of written, kind of like a handwriting 2. And if you look at the small date 2, it's curved in the middle. Looks like it was more typed in a font. If you look at Liberty, you'll notice that on the small date, which is the one on the top, it's very crisp, very clean. All the corners are real sharp. With a large date, the one on the bottom, is mushy. It has a very tired appearance, kind of overweight a little bit maybe. And if you look at the image of the motto at the top of the coin, you'll notice that the large date, the one on the bottom, the letters are fatter, mushier, misshapen. And on the top, the small date, you'll see that those letters look very crisp, clean, thin, almost very squared off. Typeset. Look at the very last T in trust. You'll see in the small date how it's so crisp. And on the large date, it's just really mushy looking. Let's talk about the different varieties of 1982 pennies. Now, if you take the Philadelphia Mint and the Denver Mint, and you take a large date and a small date, and you take zinc and a brass or copper mixture. Now, throw a little bit of that in there. A lot of people call them copper, but they're actually brass because they're 95% copper and 5% zinc, which makes a brass composition. And it's not bronze. They quit making bronze pennies in 1962 when they took the tin out of the penny. So we have the brass composition or the zinc composition. So if you take the date size, the mint, and the composition, and you take those at 2 each, and you do your math, you'll figure out there's 8 different possibilities. We have 7 of those 8 possibilities officially minted. The one that would not be minted would be the 1982D small date made of copper. We have a zinc. We don't have the copper. People have been looking since 1982 for one of those coins. And believe it or not, this past year or so, one was found. And then a second one was found. And as far as I know, there's only 2 known to this date. Now, the thing about that is 2 known out of billions minted. Billions. That's with a B. Your chances are more likely that you'll get the winning ticket for the Powerball than finding one of those coins. But just for the people who really think that they have the luck of the Irish and they're going to get out there and dig one out, it's going to be the 1982 small date from Denver made of brass or copper. All the other ones are relatively common. All the other ones are relatively easy to find and change. All the other ones are rather valueless in comparison to this one. So that's just so you know. Have fun collecting.
If you like what you see here, don't forget to like and subscribe to the Copper Coins channel on YouTube. Also, you can join us in our quest for more information by searching Copper Coins on Facebook or go to facebook.com/coppercoins.com. You can find Lincoln Cents and Lincoln Cent die varieties and eras for sale at lincolncent.com or on Copper Coins on eBay. Thanks for watching.